Hey guys, it's Renee. So to make this bag, I'm going to be using this piece of fabric I had around the house. It used to be something else. Any kind of like fabric will do. I'm going to be making this bag for this like dog hair kit just to show you how big I need it to be. So it's not going to be like super big, but it's not going to be like tiny. But yeah, for my bag, I'm going to be placing the items that I'm going to be using it for just to know like how much of fabric I need. And so I'm just going to be cutting the excess. I'm going to be using this rat tail cord in my hot glue gun. Since I'm using a piece of fabric that I folded, I pretty much need to glue two parts. So for the bottom part and one side of this, I'm going to be using my hot glue gun. Then for the top part, which is going to be making the drawstring bag, so I'm going to be cutting a bit on top, like about an inch. And then I'm going to be using this piece of plastic that came with my kit. I'm going to be cutting a part of that. This is just for when I use my hot glue. You don't have to use this piece of plastic. You can use a piece of paper, anything that will prevent you basically to glue both sides of the bag. So I'm just going to be placing my cord, folding my piece of fabric towards me to make this easier so my fabric doesn't move. I'm going to be placing a bunch of like pins, and before I do anything else, I'm going to be moving my cord around just to make sure it can move. So I'm just going to place my piece of plastic in between my like two sides of the bag, and then I'm going to hot glue that part. I'm going to work on the other side, which is like turning this pretty much upside down, doing the same thing, placing the rest of my cord, folding that piece of fabric, placing some pins. Before I go on, I'm just going to be making sure that the cord still moves. And then since I was working from the inside, I'm just going to place the outside part out. As a final step, I'm going to be making two knots on my cord just to avoid my cord going through those holes. And I think it looks prettier like this. Then I just loosened the whole bag and gave it some shape. Then I'm going to be placing the items I'm going to be placing inside. And this is pretty much it, guys. But yeah, this is the drawstring bag that I want to share with you. If you don't own a sewing machine, I think this one is handy to have. Yeah, I really hope you like this bag. Hopefully you found it easy to make, and hopefully this was handy. So if you like this, don't forget to give this a thumbs up. Check out more DIYs at home on my channel. Subscribe for more. Let me know what you think of this one and share this. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you later and take care. Bye.